2020 JEE మెయిన్ ఫలితాలలో NSR ఇంపల్స్ విద్యార్థుల ప్రభంజనం ఆల్ ఇండియా అన్ని కేటగిరీస్లో 18,551,58,71,75,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81,81, ఇంపల్స్ ఈ ఫలితాలు సాధించడానికి కారణమైన లెక్చరర్లు మరియు తల్లిదండ్రులకు మా కృతజ్ఞతలు. ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషనల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్.
లాబ్రి, డి బ్రాయిన్, వాన్ ఎకెన్స్టైన్ రీఅరేంజ్మెంట్. లాబ్రి, డి బ్రాయిన్, వాన్ ఎకెన్స్టైన్ రీఅరేంజ్మెంట్. Glucose reacts with diluted sodium hydroxide. When glucose reacts with diluted sodium hydroxide, it undergoes reversible isomerization. It undergoes reversible isomerization and gives a mixture of glucose, fructose and mannose. Gives a mixture of glucose, fructose and mannose. That is nothing but cis-enediol and trans-enediol. Cis-enediol formation, trans-enediol formation. That is nothing but mixture of glucose, fructose and mannose. Cis-enediol, trans-enediol. Okay, this reaction is called as Lavery-De Bruyne Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Lavery-De Bruyne Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Okay, what is mean by Lavery-De Bruyne Van Ekenstein rearrangement? When glucose reacts with diluted sodium hydroxide, nothing but alkali, it undergoes reversible isomerization and gives a mixture of glucose, fructose and mannose. That is nothing but cis-enediol and trans-enediol. This reaction is called as Lavery-De Bruyne Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Okay, Lavery-De Bruyne Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Yes, for example, here glucose C double bond O, hydrogen and carbon OH group, here hydrogen. Now your remaining carbon's configuration is same. This is known as D glucose. Okay, similarly here fructose is taken. Fructose CH2 OH and C double bond O. Remaining carbon's configuration is same. This is called as D glucose D fructose. And another one is mannose, CHO carbon, OH group, hydrogen, and remaining carbon's configuration is same. This is called as D mannose. Okay, D glucose, this is D mannose and D fructose. Now for this D glucose molecule, addition of base like NaOH or toluene's reagent or Fehling's reagent. Okay, toluene's reagent or Fehling's reagent or alkali is added to the glucose or mannose or fructose. Then what happen? Immediately this glucose molecule undergoes isomerization, reversible isomerization. So how it is possible? Now your carbon hydrogen sigma bonded electrons involved in the resonance, means shifting of electrons. As a result, these pi bonded electrons are shifted to oxygen. Now this hydrogen H plus migrates from carbon to oxygen. Shifting of proton from carbon to carbonylic oxygen. So indirectly it is called as tautomerism. Okay, hydrogen is shifted from carbon to carbonylic oxygen. As a result, what happened here? Carbon and OH group, here hydrogen atom, in between carbon-carbon, double bond, next here carbon atom and OH group, here configuration retained same. This is C double bond C means in two OH groups, these two OH groups are same side of the double bond, therefore cis and dione. So its name is cis in dione. For example, if the CO group is oriented left side, aldehyde group means C double bond O group is oriented right side or left side. If this carbonyl group is oriented at left side, then what happen? This OH group is obtained left side. Therefore, here carbon and OH group, hydrogen, here C double bond C, here this configuration retains same. Here another one is OH group is right side. Two OH groups are opposite direction. Hence it is called as transenediol. This is transenediol. Okay, cisenediol, transenediol formation. Cisenediol and transenediol. If alkali is added to glucose molecule, it leads to the formation of cisenediol, transenediol. Okay, so the mixture of cisenediol and transenediol is obtained. Cisenediol and transenediol is obtained. Similarly, in the case of fructose, addition of toluene's reagent or alkali or addition of Fehling's reagent, then what happened here? Carbon hydrogen sigma bonded electrons migrates between two carbon atoms. As a result, this pi bonded electrons are shifted towards carbonylic oxygen. Therefore, this hydrogen is migrates from carbon to carbonylic oxygen. What happened here? Sigma bonded electrons oriented between two carbon atoms means C double bond C. Here C double bond O group converted into OH group, hydroxy. Here OH group, OH group, two OH groups are same side. Therefore, we are getting cisenediol. This is the cisenediol formation. CC and AR. Okay, and similarly, carbonyl group means it is oriented at left side, same tautomerism takes place, OH group is at left side of the carbon. Therefore, we are getting transenediol. This is transenediol formation. Okay, it is the transenediol. Cisenediol, transenediol formation. Similarly, in the case of mannose, addition of base or tollens reagent or Fehling's reagent, what happened here? Between carbon hydrogen sigma bonded electrons shifted between the two carbons, pi bonded electrons shift towards oxygen. So as a result, this proton migrates from carbon to carbonylic oxygen. Then what happened here? OH group, carbonyl oxygen converted to OH group, here OH group, OH group, OH group opposite direction means transenediol formation. If this carbonyl oxygen is oriented at left side, your OH group left side, OH group left side, cisenediol formation. Okay, now what we are observing in this one? When glucose is treated with alkali, cisenediol formation, transenediol formation. At the same time, if fructose reacts with alkali, cisenediol formation, transenediol formation. Mannose treated with alkali, cisenediol formation, transenediol formation. So that is nothing but here, if any one, either glucose or fructose or mannose reacts with diluted NaOH or tollens reagent or Fehling's reagent to produce a mixture of glucose, mannose and fructose. That means mixture of glucose, mannose, fructose means cisenediol formation, transenediol formation. Cisenediol formation, transenediol formation. Okay, this reaction is called as Lowry, De Bruyne, Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Okay, what is Lowry, De Bruyne, Van Ekenstein rearrangement? When glucose reacts with alkali, it undergoes reversible isomerization and gives a mixture of glucose, fructose, mannose, means cisenediol and transenediol. So this reaction is called as Lowry, De Bruyne, Van Ekenstein rearrangement. Okay, now in this one important question is there, important question, fructose gives positive tollens and Fehling's, fructose gives positive tollens and Fehling's test, explain. Okay, fructose gives positive tollens test and also positive Fehling's test, explain. Tollens test and Fehling's test is given by aldehydes, ketones negative tollens test and Fehling's test, but in fructose keto group is present. Presence of keto group, negative tollens test and Fehling's test. But fructose gives positive tollens test and Fehling's test. Why? That is the question. Okay, fructose, in fructose molecule keto group is present, therefore it is negative tollens and Fehling's test. But glucose, it is having a aldehyde group. Mannose, it is also possess aldehyde group. Presence of aldehyde group, D-glucose and D-mannose gives positive tollens test and Fehling's test. But ketone, negative tollens and Fehling's test. Because of presence of keto group, absence of aldehyde group. If aldehyde group is present, it is given by positive tollens test and Fehling's test. But in this keto group is present, even though fructose gives positive tollens and Fehling's test, explain. Okay, so question is, In fructose molecule, keto group is present even though it gives positive tolerance test and failings test. Explain. Reason: when fructose treated with tolerance reagent or failings reagent, that is nothing but alkali. So fructose on treatment with tolerance reagent or failings reagent, immediately this fructose is converted into a mixture of glucose and mannose. Glucose and mannose is nothing but cis-indiol formation, trans-indiol formation. Cis-indiol, trans-indiol is nothing but it is a mixture of D-glucose and D-mannose. In D-glucose and D-mannose, aldehyde group is present. That's why fructose is also gives positive tolerance test and positive failings test. Okay, this is very, very important question. Why fructose gives tolerance and failings test? Fructose gives positive tolerance test and positive failings test even though absence of aldehyde group, because of the reason is when fructose is treated with tolerance reagent and failings reagent, immediately it is undergoes reversible isomerization and produces a mixture of D-glucose and D-mannose. That's why it is given by positive tolerance test and positive failings test. So D-glucose, D-mannose and D-fructose, these three compounds are treated with tolerance reagent to form silver mirror formation, AG, and similarly they are reacts with the failings reagent to produce red color precipitate, that is cuprous oxide, Cu2O. Okay, this reaction is called as Labrie-De Bruijn van Ekenstein rearrangement. This is very, very important question. Okay, why fructose gives positive tolerance failings test? Because of Labrie-De Bruijn van Ekenstein rearrangement. Fructose on treatment with alkali, immediately it is undergoes reversible isomerization to form a mixture of D-glucose, D-mannose and D-fructose. That's why it is given by positive tolerance test and positive failings test. Next concept is muta rotation. What is mean by muta rotation? Okay, what is the meaning of muta rotation? Muta rotation. Yes, muta rotation means glucose glucose crystallized, glucose crystallized from glucose crystallized 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 from glucose crystallized from diluted solution at 30 degree centigrade to give alpha D plus glucose. Alpha D plus glucose. Okay, alpha D plus glucose with melting point 146 degree centigrade. Okay, glucose crystallized from diluted solution at 30 degree centigrade to give alpha D plus glucose with melting point 146 degree centigrade. Now this glucose recrystallized from this glucose recrystallized from water, recrystallized from water exhibits specific rotation plus 112 degrees. As time passes, specific rotation decreases up to plus 52.5 degrees. Okay, this is known as muta rotation. What is meant by muta rotation? Glucose crystallized from diluted solution at 30 degree centigrade temperature. Alpha D plus glucose with melting point is 146 degree centigrade. This glucose recrystallized from water exhibits specific rotation 112 degrees. As time passes, the specific rotation decreases up to plus 52.5 degrees. Here, as time passes, specific rotation changes with change in time. Specific rotation changes with change in time is called as muta rotation. Okay, similarly, and one more, a glucose crystallized from hot saturated aqueous solution at 98 degree centigrade to give beta D plus glucose with melting point 150 degree centigrade temperature. Now this glucose recrystallized from acetic acid CH3COH, acetic acid exhibits specific rotation plus 19 degrees. As time passes, specific rotation increases up to increases up to plus 52.5 degrees. Here also say glucose crystallized from hot saturated aqueous solution at 98 degrees centigrade temperature to give beta D plus glucose. Okay, formation of beta D plus glucose with the melting point is 150 degrees centigrade. This glucose recrystallized from acetic acid CH3COH. It is recrystallized from acetic acid, exhibits plus 19 degrees, initially plus 19 degrees. As time passes, specific rotation increases up to plus 52.5 degrees. Okay, what we are observing in this one? As time passes, specific rotation is also changes. Specific rotation changes with change in time is called as mutarotation. Okay, simply, what is the meaning of specific rotation? Specific rotation means here as time passes, specific rotation changes. Specific rotation changes with change in time is called as mutarotation. So, in this case, for example, here glucose CHO glucose molecule CHO CH2 OH, OH group, hydrogen, hydrogen and OH group, OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen. This is open chain structure of glucose. Okay, D plus glucose. This is the open chain structure of glucose molecule. Now, this open chain structure of glucose molecule is recrystallized from water. It gives alpha D plus glucose. So, alpha D plus glucopyranose means MeSol ring structure. Here, 6-membered ring structure. Okay, like this. Carbon, OH group and hydrogen, CH2, OH, OH group, hydrogen, hydrogen and OH group, OH group, hydrogen and hydrogen. This is cyclic MeSol structure. Okay, this is called as alpha D plus glucopyranose because of OH group is right side of first carbon. So, this is called as alpha D plus glucopyranose. Alpha D plus glucopyranose. Similarly, now this glucose molecule is recrystallized from acetic acid. Recrystallized from acetic acid, it gives beta D plus glucopyranose. OH and CH2, OH 1, 2, 3, 4 chiral carbons. This is cyclic MeSol structure. Okay, cyclic MeSol structure. OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen and hydrogen. This is called as beta D plus glucopyranose. Beta D plus glucopyranose. Beta means at first carbon OH group is left side. At first carbon OH group is right side, that is alpha. At first carbon OH group is left side, beta. So D glucose, which is recrystallized from water, formation of alpha D plus glucose. If it is recrystallized from acetic acid, beta D plus glucopyranose. So alpha D plus glucopyranose, beta D plus glucopyranose. Alpha D plus glucose, initially its specific rotation is specific rotation of alpha D glucose, specific rotation is equal to plus 112 degrees. Okay, this is the specific rotation of alpha D plus glucose. Initially plus 112 degrees. Now this 112 degrees specific rotation decreases up to 52.5. So therefore, here it is reaches to alpha D is equal to plus 52.5 degrees. Okay, this is plus 52.5 degrees. Similarly, this glucose is recrystallized from acetic acid. It is given by beta D plus glucose. Beta D plus glucose initial specific rotation is plus 19 degrees. plus 19 degrees specific rotation. As time passes, this 19 degrees specific rotation changes to plus 52.5 degrees. Here initially alpha D glucose specific rotation is plus 112 degrees, its specific rotation decreases up to plus 52.5 degrees. So these are in equilibrium with each other, alpha D glucose and beta D glucose. Alpha D glucose means at first carbon OH group is right side, beta D glucose means at first carbon OH group is left side. Okay, so these two are equilibrium with each other. At this equilibrium state, its specific rotation is plus 52.5 degrees. Okay, what is the meaning of mutual rotation? Simply, mutual rotation means specific rotation changes with change in time is called as mutual rotation. Okay, alpha D glucose initial specific rotation is plus 112 degrees. As time passes, the specific rotation reaches to plus 52.5 degrees. Beta D glucose specific rotation initially plus 19 degrees. The specific rotation increases up to plus 52.5 degrees by time passing. So that means here mutual rotation is nothing but specific rotation changes with change in time is called as mutual rotation. Mutual rotation is exhibited by only cyclic structure of glucose. Cyclic hemiacetal structure of glucose is exhibited by mutual rotation. Open chain structure of glucose does not exhibit mutual rotation. Okay, open chain structure of glucose does not exhibit mutual rotation. Only cyclic structure of glucose exhibits mutual rotation. Okay, this is about mutual rotation. So alpha D glucose is obtained, which is recrystallized from water. Beta D glucose is obtained, which is recrystallized from acetic acid. So alpha means OH group is right side at first carbon. Beta D glucose means OH group is left side at first carbon. So which one is the more stable? Beta D glucose is more stable. Here 64% of beta D glucose exist, 64%, and alpha D glucose is only 36%. So most stable form is beta form. Beta D plus glucopyranose is more stable than alpha D plus glucopyranose. Okay, so how to explain the stability of alpha and beta D glucoses? Alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose. Stability orders. First, alpha D plus glucopyranose, OH group, hydrogen, CH2 OH group, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons, OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen and hydrogen. Now this is the alpha D plus glucopyranose. Alpha D plus gluco, alpha D plus glucopyranose, alpha D plus glucopyranose. Alpha means OH group at first carbon is right side. This is alpha D plus glucopyranose. Glucopyranose means 6-membered ring structure. Similarly, beta, carbon, hydrogen and OH group, CH2, OH, 1, 2, 3, 4 chiral carbons, oxygen and OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen, OH group, hydrogen and hydrogen. Now in this, at first carbon OH group is left side, hence it is called as beta D plus glucopyranose. పైరనోస్, బీటా డి ప్లస్ గ్లూకో పైరనోస్, ఆల్ఫా డి ప్లస్ గ్లూకో పైరనోస్, బీటా డి ప్లస్ గ్లూకో పైరనోస్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఆల్ఫా అండ్ బీటా? ఎట్ ఫస్ట్ కార్బన్ ఓఎహెచ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ రైట్ సైడ్ ఆల్ఫా, ఎట్ ఫస్ట్ కార్బన్ ఓఎహెచ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ బీటా. ఓకే, నౌ ఫర్ దిస్ ఆల్ఫా డి ప్లస్ గ్లూకో పైరనోస్ సాచురేటెడ్ సిక్స్ మెంబర్డ్ రింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ యాజ్ ఏ చైర్స్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్స్, చైర్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్స్ అండ్ హావర్త్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్స్. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ హియర్ హావర్త్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్స్, హావర్త్ స్ట్రక్చర్, హావర్త్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ఫా డి ప్లస్ గ్లూకోజ్ అండ్ ఆల్సో చైర్ కన్ఫర్మేషన్స్, chair conformation or chair structure of alpha d glucose. At Haworth conformation, six membered ring structure like this, 1 2 3 4 5, six membered. So this six membered ring structure is written like this. Okay, this is the six membered ring structure. It is six membered ring structure. Here oxygen, ఫస్ట్ కార్బన్, సెకండ్ కార్బన్, థర్డ్ కార్బన్, ఫోర్త్ కార్బన్, ఫిఫ్త్ కార్బన్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద సిక్స్ మెంబర్డ్ ఆవర్త్ రింగ్ స్ట్రక్చర్. హౌ టు రైట్ ద స్ట్రక్చర్స్? యర్ రైట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ ఆర్ బిలో, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ ఆర్ అబవ్. ఓకే, యూ మస్ట్ రిమెంబర్ రైట్ గ్రూప్స్, రైట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ బిలో, రైట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ బిలో, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ అబవ్. రైట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ బిలో, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ అబవ్. ఎస్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఫస్ట్ కార్బన్ అండ్ సెకండ్ కార్బన్, థర్డ్ కార్బన్, ఫోర్త్ కార్బన్, ఫిఫ్త్ అండ్ సిక్స్త్. ఎట్ ఫస్ట్ కార్బన్ ఓహెచ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ రైట్ సైడ్, సో బిలో, ఓహెచ్ గ్రూప్ రైట్ సైడ్ బిలో. హైడ్రోజన్ లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ అబవ్. రైట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ బిలో, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ గ్రూప్స్ అబవ్. సెకండ్ కార్బన్ ఓహెచ్ గ్రూప్ రైట్ సైడ్, సో బిలో, ఇయర్ హైడ్రోజన్ అబవ్. థర్డ్ ఓహెచ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ అబవ్, హైడ్రోజన్ బిలో. ఫోర్త్ ఓహెచ్ గ్రూప్ ఈజ్ బిలో, రైట్ సైడ్ అండ్ హైడ్రోజన్. ఎట్ ఫిఫ్త్ పొజిషన్ హైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ సిహెచ్ టూ గ్రూప్స్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్ విత్ ఈచ్ అదర్, ఎక్స్చేంజ్ విత్ ఈచ్ అదర్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ బిలో బట్ అబవ్ డైరెక్షన్. సిహెచ్ టూ ఓహెచ్ అండ్ హెచ్, సిహెచ్ టూ ఓహెచ్ ఇయర్ హైడ్రోజన్. This is the Haworth structure of alpha D plus glucopyranose. Similarly for beta, here also same, right side groups below, left side groups above. Here six membered ring structure like this, it is the six membered ring structure, 1 2 3 4 5, this is six member ring. At first carbon and second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon. At first carbon OH group is left side, OH group left side means above, here OH group is above, hydrogen below. At second carbon OH group is right side, below, hydrogen above. Third OH group is above, hydrogen below. Fourth OH group below, hydrogen above. Here also same, at fifth position 1 2 3 4 5 6 member, here hydrogen and CH2 OH groups are exchange with each other, so here CH2 OH group and hydrogen, this is beta D plus glucopyranose. Alpha D plus glucopyranose Haworth structure, this is beta D plus glucopyranose Haworth structure, alpha and beta. Then how to write the chair conformation? Chair conformation of alpha D plus glucopyranose, any saturated six membered ring is exist as chair conformation. So therefore your chair conformation, chair structure is like this. This is the chair conformation. Here it is oxygen. It is the six membered ring structure chair conformation. Now it is first carbon, second, third, fourth and fifth oxygen 6. Same, right side groups are below, left side groups are above. So therefore here above hydrogen, below OH group. Second carbon OH group is below, OH group is below, hydrogen is above. At third position OH group is above, hydrogen is below. Fourth OH group is below side and hydrogen is above. Here reverse exchange with each other, therefore CH2OH is above, hydrogen is below. This is the chair conformation of alpha D plus glucopyranose. This is the chair conformation. Similarly for beta, here chair conformation of beta D plus glucopyranose is beta D plus glucopyranose. Only at first carbon OH group is different. So therefore here OH group is above, hydrogen is below, remaining all are same, hydrogen and OH group, here OH group, hydrogen. Similarly here OH group, hydrogen, and CH2 OH group and hydrogen. This is beta D plus glucopyranose. Okay, alpha D plus glucopyranose, Haworth structure. This is beta D plus glucopyranose, Haworth structure. Chair conformation of alpha D plus glucopyranose, chair conformation of beta D plus glucopyranose. What is the difference here? In alpha D plus glucopyranose, OH group is below. In beta D plus glucopyranose, OH group is above direction. OH group is above. In chair conformation, here OH group is below, here OH group is above. Okay, among these alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose, which one is more stable? So stability of alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose is identified by using the position of a substitution in the chair conformation. Position of a substitution in the chair conformation. Right, in cyclohexane structure, in cyclohexane chair conformation, in cyclohexane chair conformation, 6 equatorial positions, 6 equatorial positions and 6 axial positions. This is axial, here it is axial position, and axial. So in cyclohexane, 6 axial positions and 6 equatorial positions are present. Okay, two types of positions are possible, axial and equatorial. The substitution which is present at equatorial position is more stable than axial position. Okay, equatorial substitution, stability order, equatorial substitution is more stable than axial substitution. Okay, equatorial substitution is more stable than axial substitution. Right, now in this case, in alpha D plus glucopyranose, C1 carbon OH group is below. C1 carbon OH group is below means axial. This is axial position. Okay, axial position. At C2 carbon OH group is there. C2 carbon OH group equatorial. Similarly, C3 carbon, third carbon OH group is also equatorial position. So, C3 carbon OH group is also equatorial. C4 carbon OH group is also equatorial position. And C5 CH2OH group is also equatorial. C5 CH2OH group is also equatorial. So in alpha D plus glucopyranose, C1OH group is axial, C1 carbon OH group is in axial, C2, C3, C4, C5 carbons OH groups are equatorial positions. So 4 hydroxyl groups are in equatorial positions and 1 OH group is in axial position. Similarly, in beta D plus glucopyranose, C1 carbon OH group is equatorial position. C1 carbon OH group is equatorial, C2 carbon OH group is also equatorial, C3 carbon OH group is also equatorial, C4 carbon OH group is also equatorial, and at C5 carbon CH2 OH group is also equatorial. That means all are in equatorial position. In alpha D plus glucopyranose, first carbon OH group is axial, remaining all are equatorial. But in beta D plus glucopyranose, all are in equatorial positions. So according to stability, equatorial substitutions are more stable than axial substitutions. Therefore, by the comparison of alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose, beta D plus glucopyranose is more stable than alpha D plus glucopyranose. So therefore, your stability order is alpha D plus gluco, alpha D plus glucopyranose, alpha D plus glucopyranose is less stable than beta D plus glucopyranose. Alpha D plus glucopyranose is less stable than beta D plus glucopyranose. So that's why alpha D plus glucopyranose exists in 36%, beta D plus glucopyranose exists in 64%. Okay, why it is more stable? All the substitutions are in equatorial positions. Here beta alpha is less stable because of at first carbon OH group is axial. So stability order, equatorial substitution is more stable than axial substitution. So that's why by the comparison of alpha D plus glucopyranose and beta D plus glucopyranose, beta D plus glucopyranose is more stable. That's why it is exist in 64%, and alpha D plus glucopyranose is less stable. It is exist in 36% only. Okay, so these are the chair conformations and Haworth structures of cyclic structure of glucose.